The spirit of this program is to bring in and celebrate our senior class, the hard work of everybody in the band, our 9th through 12th graders, but also to just put that special gold star on the seniors. Some of them have endured, experienced 7 years of our jokes and, you know, lots of experiences and fond memories. You will have a musical presentation that I hope leaves you with goosebumps from the hard work of the students all year long. I hope that you'll have a moment to reflect, as we have a student-generated year-in-review slideshow. We have a little senior slideshow where we play Guess the Pictures. We have it all, ladies and gentlemen, and I think we have a lot to celebrate. All's I've heard about in media articles about, the students these days, they just don't have any grit. If you've been an instrumentalist and started at the beginning, which we all do, those special sounds, let's call it that, shall we? And you have now transformed yourself in 4 years to 7 years. No, 8 years, just to make sure you know. But in that time, transform and make beautiful music and truly enjoy this living, breathing art form we call music. I hope you enjoy this concert and all of the things that we can present tonight. It will be a little bit later and we would invite you at the end to join us for a banquet. I don't believe we have coffee, but just pretend, and we're looking forward to celebrating with you. This is our event so much.
Thank you. Our next tune is titled Ballad Air. This was written, I believe, in the later 1950s by Frank Erickson. And he was a band composer, wrote, I guess, what was considered new music back in the 1950s. And this is kind of based on a dance form. So we hope you enjoy this. It's a slower piece, and it's one of those classics I think every band student ought to play at one point when they in their band career. So we hope you enjoy Frank Erickson's Ballad Air. Next tune is standard ABA form, or fast, slow, fast. I call it Oreo cookie form. The crunchy beginning, and the creamy, slow middle, and then the crunchy ending, which is kind of like the beginning. And this is called Celebration in Song, and celebration of all of our great things that happened in our band program this year, celebrating our seniors that will be leaving us here very shortly. And so we hope you enjoy Robert Shelton's Celebration in Song. So our next two is kind of a programmatic work, and that tells a story. And this one happens to tell a story of a trip to the zoo and some of the souvenirs you might bring back. And thinking in combining souvenirs in the zoo, we have Zoovenirs by Randall Sandridge. And it's 9 short movements, so don't get too freaked out when you look at your program and see 9 movements, and they're about 20 measures, 25 measures each. And I thought, you know, this would be a great opportunity to do some multimedia work. And I'd like to thank Corey Zaverna and Lindsay Brown for putting together a little slideshow to fit and our piece here. And I would also like to thank Annalise Marks for agreeing to move the clicker as we go through our trip to the zoo. So we hope you enjoy Zoovenirs. Maybe a little bit of audience participation, but we don't want to get too crazy, okay? Thank you. Thank you.
we make a transition, if I could bring June Murray Dale up to the stage, who's representing the band Boosters. And how about while we're transitioning, how about one more hand for Symphonic Band? Wasn't that awesome?
Somewhere in the room. If you are, I need you to come forward. I'm not seeing movement. Mrs. Larson? Okay. Well, that didn't work out so well. That's okay. He can present. All right. So my name is Kim, and this is June. We are both with Band Boosters, but tonight we're representing two different groups. She'll be representing the Band Boosters, and I'm representing the senior parents this year. So there's, what, 24 of us, I believe, that have seniors graduating this year. Break my heart. We wanted to actually, as the senior parents, we put together a donation, so thank for all of those of you who did that. We have a couple things. For Mrs. Larson, who is not in the house, Mike actually moved you over here, sorry. These are flowers for her, so if someone could give her the message, thank you for all of her time and service, because their wives, I'm sure, just love how much they're not home. So that's for her. I'm going to give you those because I need a free hand. Yes. And funny thing we realized, I believe this is your sixth year, correct? Okay, so what that means is the seniors that are in the audience, that Mr. Larson has been with you guys since
seventh grade.
So pretty much almost your entire time, right? Like plus or minus a year, whatever. So we also have one more thing we'd like to present to Mr. Larson. I'm just gonna have you pull that out and I will read that in a second. This is just a quick certificate of sorts of what we raised to do. So it says, certificate of appreciation for Mr. Michael Larson. In honor of your work and dedication to the Hanslet Band Program, a seat in your name has been purchased for the Hanslet High School Performing Arts Center. Thank you service for our students, our school, and our community via the senior band parents class of 2018. So we will have a seat number for him. Thank you.
Well, that brings tears to my eyes. And we're not done yet because these gentlemen put in hundreds of hours, as you all know, and they are paid like all the other teachers. The other teachers are done the 1st of June. These guys are just getting started. Hundreds of hours during band camp week, all of that, mostly out of the goodness of their heart, because we know how teachers are paid, and it's not for how much they put into it. It's, unfortunately, that's a whole other topic. Okay, so for the wife of Mr. Gott, because she is so generous to lend him to our band family. We really appreciate it. And if you count up all those hundreds and hundreds of hours, over 15 years, that is a lot of hours. I'm speaking for the Band Boosters, in case I didn't tell you. And let's get it out, babe. And some glasses. I can't read. With the clear tears in my eyes, okay? It's upside down. Hanslet Band Boosters would like to recognize Mr. David Gott in appreciation for his 15 years of outstanding and dedicated service as director of the Hanslet Band Program. 2003 to 2018. Thank you for your service to our students, our school, and our community. May 22nd, 2018.
Thank you very much, and plan to be here for a lot longer, so thank you very much. Though if somebody does take a picture, Photoshop for my hair would be nice. Thank you very much, Band Boosters, and thank you, parents. You know, we, Mike and I, really appreciate all of the effort that everybody does. I don't care if it's sending email, coming out in the sun, helping our students with a meal. Anytime that you're available and you're helping all of these kids, and we really appreciate it. And just cannot thank you enough as parents for all the support you give the program. So thank you.
Would you please play a few notes, make sure things are working? Our first piece is in five movements, and the band version of The Louvre is taken from the original score of the NBC television special that was first broadcast nationally in November of 1964. In September of 65, the composer received the Emmy Award for this score as the most outstanding music written for television in the season of 1964 and 65. The five movements of the suite cover the period of the Louvre's development during the Renaissance. Here, themes are used from composers of that time. Edward Downes, the noted critic, has written about this work a strong melodic vein, rhythmic vitality, and infectious brio of freshness of inventions are among the earmarks of Dello Gioia's style. The band work commissioned by Baldwin-Wallace College for the Baldwin-Wallace Symphonic Band, Kenneth Snapp, conductor, was premiered on March 13th of 1966, conducted by the composer. The movements are, and we'll just take a very short pause in between them, The Portals, Children's Gallery, The Kings of France, The Nativity Paintings, and Finale. We hope you enjoy Scenes from the Louvre.
Thank you.
So our next piece is Yesu, Joy of Man's Desiring. It's a transcription actually written by the conductor of the Eastman Wind Ensemble, Donna Hunsberger. I should have said arranged, Bach wrote it. And you'll see that we've expanded our instrumentation. There's even more that we could do, but we're really thrilled with the students that have added to the ensemble, rehearsed with the ensemble, worked on these newer instruments to them, and we hope you enjoy Yesu, Joy of Man's Desiring.
Thank you.
Our next tune we're going to perform this evening is a compilation of some sub-Saharan countries in Africa, folk songs from sub-Saharan Africa countries. And so we hope you enjoy Sub-Saharan Rhythms by David Gillingham.
Thank you.
Our last piece for wind ensemble is a 3-movement work. We'll take just a little pause in between them. It is Suite on Celtic Folk Songs, and you'll certainly hear the style from that area of the world. It is a march, it is an air, and it is a reel. It goes real quick. I won't demonstrate the dancing, but it's wonderful. We hope you enjoy Suite on Celtic Folk Songs.
Thank you. moment to transition into full band.
Well, thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for your patience while we change. Thank you, students, for moving so quickly. Can we say it was a great year? Yeah. I promise that I'll be brief because it's just a lot of fun to talk about these kids and their accomplishments. It really is. For service, our students have put together a can drive, actually two, hosting solo and ensemble. Was that an undertaking? You volunteered and helped with solo and ensemble when we hosted in February 3rd this year. Please raise your hand. Thank you very much for doing that. I appreciate that. One of the things that's so nice is the students on stage are oftentimes paired with middle schoolers, 6th, 7th, and 8th graders that are helping out for the first, maybe second, possibly third time. And one of the comments that I hear from middle schoolers all the time is how nicely treated they are from the high schoolers, and I think that just shows the great character that this band has, these individuals. District Solo and Ensemble, as I told you, we hosted, our band boosters hosted this event. We had 25, 26 schools represented. Starts very early in the day, ends very late, and Friday as well. Though we did have record time again, we spoiled. It's been wonderful. And if you were a participant in District Solo and Ensemble, high school students, if you were a participant in District Solo and Ensemble, please stand and be recognized. High school, the district's own ensemble, which continues to grow to 50 events this year. Many students qualified for state solo ensemble by earning a first division in district, and they performed in March at Oakland's. Oakland's this year. They changed it so quick. But if you were a participant in state solo ensemble, would you please stand and be recognized? Freshman solo, you play your solo. If you are a sophomore, junior, or senior, you get the luxury of playing what's called a proficiency exam. Doesn't it sound fun already? Yes, and the students are then graded on their solo. There's 50 points in their solo for tone, technique, intonation, interpretation, and rhythm. However, there's also an added two components. One is that you have a list of major and minor scales to play in various octaves and a chromatic. That's for 25 points. We tell the students 25 is just, they give you all the answers, just go get them. And then, of course, sight reading, which is the unknown, and that's worth 25 points. And out of all of that, students were very successful. In fact, we'd like to recognize Julie Anna Marks and Annalise Marks. They qualified on their proficiency 3, which is everything in the kitchen sink, and scored high enough to be a part of the Michigan Youth Arts Festival band this year. So please give them a round of applause. Competition, and for our calendar, it happens on Friday of spring break. And we had 4 students this year nominated on the plane of their solo for proficiency. They got 50 out of 50 to do this, which is incredible. Didn't even take 1 point away. Can you believe it? And they were nominated for Michigan Youth Arts Festival Outstanding Soloists. And they went, some of them went and auditioned over spring break. Some had plans and other things, but it was really amazing. Did I mention they have to play from memory? So we're very proud of these students. Less than 100 in the entire state. We figured it out to be 0.007%. And you trust my math? I'm guaranteeing you that that's high. So please congratulate Juliana Marks, Annalise Marks, Megan Fulton, and Carmen Urban. Being in this area is just so wonderful. Not only are there great lesson teachers, but we have the full support of Michigan State. Michigan State, a number of years back, started this very cool honors band. It's a different philosophy than most. They meet every Sunday during the semester and give a performance in December and also in April, early May. And we had 2 participants, and that would be Juliana Marks and Marisha Curtis. Please congratulate them. Also representing us in a really exciting opportunity for students to get full orchestra experience and whatnot. And our Mid-Michigan Youth Symphony meets once a week as well and put on some great performance. And please congratulate her participation this year, Maria Miklacic.
Take this time to recognize our underclassmen for all the efforts that they have put in this year. Starting with our freshman class, there's been a great group of students to work with, and they've done a wonderful job of adjusting to the high expectations and the demands of high school, and they'll be a great contributing class all the way through their high school career. Many of them attended our leadership workshop, participated in solo and ensemble, and have taken private lessons and volunteered their time to help band and more. So if you're a freshman, would you please rise and stand for recognition? The sophomore class has been a hardworking, dynamic bunch of students. They have continued to grow in their role more and more as leaders in our bands and have helped to be mentors and work in sectionals. They have continued to take private lessons, participate in solo and ensemble, and give time to the extra events in our program. It's obvious they are no longer rookies at this. We are looking forward to seeing what they do as upperclassmen next year. So if you're a sophomore, would you please rise for recognition? And the juniors, next year's seniors, that's hard to believe. I believe they were my first class here. Hazlitt. They're a great group that holds the energy and the ability to be next year's seniors class. So if you're a soon-to-be senior, would you please stand for recognition?
Seniors, as I call off your name, please come up to the front of the stage and be recognized. Ladies and gentlemen, if you would hold your applause to the end, we would appreciate it. Sally Owa.
Thank you for holding your applause.
Lydia Clarice. Alex Dale. Elise Hendricks. Felicity Probal. Megan Fulton. Matt Garnett. Jay Han. Madison Held. Susanna Henry. Jack Lehman. Annalise Marks. Juliana Marks. Kyle Van Biela. Kristen Mikasa. Maria McLeod. Aiden Morton. Kevin Murray. Chris Orr. Emma Pichet. Lexi Salazar. Kian Scott. Jake Teichman. And Carmen Herborn. I can't tell you how many medals, how many ratings. I can say things like war, flash mob, middle school. I can't begin to describe, nor could I wouldn't do it, and it would take way too long to describe, but I will tell you that each person up on this stage, Mr. Larson or I, could have one or two, or really a lot of stories about. Like that, we can certainly send that to you if you need it for an open house. We'll always help you. But really, thank you, seniors, for all of your dedication throughout your high school career. You will be greatly missed. And please, let's give a round of applause for our senior class. Seniors, we have some special awards this evening, awards that are rich with tradition and honor. We will continue to keep a record of these award winners in our band program, and we'll display them proudly here at Hazlett High School. Although, seniors, you are all award winners, we would like to recognize the following seniors for their outstanding achievements.
We're going to begin with the MSVOA, that's the Michigan School Band and Orchestra Association, Scholar Instrumentalist Award. The MSVOA started the Instrument Scholars Award to be awarded to a contributing member who has performed in at least one MSVOA-sponsored event, such as solo and ensemble, in addition to carrying a high grade point average. We are happy to recognize the 2018 MSVOA Scholar Instrumentalist, Maria Mikalcic.
special award this year, and one that is going to start to continue. Our next award goes to the individual that's held this position for 3 years. Center snare is a high honor earned by a student who has practiced and refined a technical skill along with demonstrating quality leadership ability. We would like to award the center snare award to Aiden Morton.
Student leadership is extremely important to the success of any group. We would not have had the success this year without it. The next two seniors are great examples of student leaders, and I'm sure they will serve as tomorrow's leaders as well. The number of times that these two young leaders have met to work out plans and truly make our band an excellent organization to be part of are too numerous to count. Please join me in congratulating this year's drum majors, Annalise Marks and Juliana Marks.
It takes a lot of work to lead and have the energy to be band council president. What does that entail? Well, number one, you have to come in and have a Monday morning meeting with us, 7 o'clock. Number two, you have to run the band council meeting. And number three, when people don't volunteer, you have to cheerlead them too and join them. Plus, as your band council presidents this year, the following individuals have worked with a team of terrific students from grades 9 through 12 to plan band activities, fundraising, organizing ushers for our middle school concerts, coordinating community performances, and so much more. Please join me in congratulating this year's band council co-presidents, Juliana Marks and Maria McLeod.
True loyalty to the group, performed at a high level, and demonstrated honor and commitment in service and leadership. Please welcome, if he's here, our Marine recruiter, Sergeant Jones, to the stage for the presentation.
Seniors have, they've been determined leaders as well. They've been great role models and extremely giving to our program. These seniors have been active leaders, volunteers, and dedicated in every sense of the word. This year's Director's Awards go to Susanna Henry and Lexi Salazar.
This award is traditionally given to seniors who have shown commitment to and ability with jazz, some of them even learning second instruments. These seniors have been great and committed members of our jazz ensemble. Please join me in congratulating for the Louis Armstrong Award, Felicity Froban and Kevin Murray.
This time, we have a small presentation on behalf of our band boosters for senior scholarships. Please, to present that, can we please welcome Lori DeBruin.
He's so thankful all the time. We want to thank you. Thank you all for coming out for this celebratory evening. Really to celebrate our teenagers for their amazing accomplishments. Thank you all. But also our directors. Without our directors, this would not be happening. And that also is how our band boosters run. Without all of you, we cannot do what we do. We truly, truly, truly thank you for all the volunteer work, whether it's secretly putting cash in the box, we do know this, thank you. For buying cookie dough, for buying Vanetta gift certificates, for supporting the craft show, for telling your friends about the craft show, for solo ensemble, for everything that you do. We truly see it, and it does not go unnoticed. We cannot function without you guys. So thank you very, very much. In addition to that, we also have many opening spots for volunteers in the future. The emails do go out all of the time. And it's not because we're begging, but we truly believe that it takes a village to raise a family, and we are one big happy family. And on that note, because we have the funding that we are able to have, we are able to, as a band boosters, but also because you provided us scholarships for two of our seniors. And I would like to present our Henry Nelson Scholarship is for a non-major for music, and that goes to Annalise Mark. For our great Quincy music major, this young lady is going to focus on music for the rest of her life, which is truly a gift, and that will be to Juliana Marks. Someone that can hem, someone that can mend, all of their wonderful concert uniforms and our band concert. So if you know anybody that would like to get into sewing or mending our costumes, you definitely need that. Our meetings are typically the second Thursday of the month, and you're more than welcome to join us. It's not just for board members, it's for all parents. Thank you.
Our next two seniors have had outstanding attitudes as well. Their work ethic and commitment have been invaluable to their section and our band as a whole. Please join me in congratulating for the Patrick Gilmore Award, Megan Fulton and Jay Hahn. Thank you.
excuse me, at the auditorium, we won't provide you coffee. But I'm going to tell you, again, we could talk about every one of these kids on stage and what awesome things they do. The John Philip Sousa Award. This award is reserved for the top senior performers within our band. We are very fortunate in Hazlitt, as you've heard, to have many students who work hard and perform very well. So it's always difficult to select recipients for these awards. Makes this concert tough, but also exciting. These two individuals have shown leadership, dedication, and performance ability far above the expectation consistently throughout their high school career. Please join me in congratulating Annalise Marks and Juliana Marks.
Fit me, they were either like way too big or way too small, and Mrs. Membiala made one from scratch for me. She measured it and made it just for me, and that was really special. So, and these two people, just if you've ever thought the band looked really good, give it up to them. Directors out here. Mr. Gott and Mr. Larson spend so much time dedicated to the students. Obviously, it's pretty evident that they care a lot more about just teaching us the music. They care about us as people, and it's been a great 7/6 years. they're here so much, and there's so much time. I think I've beaten Mr. Gott to school once in all of high school when it was NHS blood drive, and he was there like 2 minutes later, and I was there at like 6 a.m.
The appreciation of the senior class.
Cherished memories that we'll have, and even with my memory, I won't forget
appreciation of. So thank you very much for everything. How about it? Once again, Mark. The piece that we'd like to present to you this evening is called The Critical Mass. And our science students in here taught me that that's an important point where all of the energy happens. And I think that you'll hear that Todd Stalter really captured that. We hope that you enjoy Critical Mass.
Thank you.
few minutes here and put the band in the seats here for a couple of presentations. The first is kind of a year in review, and can you guess that senior? So if you'll look on the side streets here momentarily, we'll have our presentation.
Nice and careful, very easy. Just go faster. As 15 or 20 students are moving off, I think it would be a great time to acknowledge also people that are behind the scenes that make this happen. First, our video TV22 production crew, Mr. Dutcher leading the way, and our students that are here with smiles on, moving equipment, they'll be moving it back later as well. How about a big thank you to our TV22 crew? Students that are part of this as well, and led by Pat Hepfer. We have Aaron on sound and Alana backstage making sure that things are working, and just so much help. And it's really wonderful if you're involved in music production, play production, choir, band, doesn't matter, they're here. How about a big special thank you to Mr. Pat Hepfer for all of his time. And put together a little presentation.
Thank you. Faces of people going by.
Before our next part of the program, I would like to invite a couple people up to the stage. We have Kelly Flagg from the Hazlitt Foundation has a brief presentation.
Very brief. I've certainly enjoyed myself tonight to come and give my 1 minute presentation to Mr. Gott. I am Kelly Flagg and I'm president of the Foundation for Hazlitt Schools. We raise money to fund beyond the fundamentals. As a matter of fact, we've raised over $65,000 for the renovation of the Performing Arts Center. So tonight, it is my privilege, though, to give an award because we have an anonymous donation for all of the efforts that Mr. Gott has done, and certainly tonight shows that. He gets what's called the Hats Off Award. A donation has been made to the foundation in his name, and we get to take a lovely picture of Mr. Gott with his hat.
So we got a seniors, we're sorry, but we have to talk about the new things happening too. So I know last year there were many good guesses with our baby show trivia that we had. However,
brief presentation.
I'm not gonna just tell you. Singing, just so you know. Got a lot of energy, but they had to sit. That is quite a payoff. Look at that form. Yep, time to do it again. Oh, man. Can you see that? It says on a scale of 1 to 5, your show this year. It's a high five. We'll figure it out. Don't share. You might not be able to see it. It says we've got to hand it to you, this year's girl designers, Ms. Krauss. No, I hear incorrect guesses out there. No. As we work on this year's show, we may even be... That's a power word. Hey, easy there, you're still running. I'm kidding. Here you go. So, all of those tunes have a tie to our Michigan, and that's our peer show. I hope that you enjoy that. All right, ladies and gentlemen, yeah, peer Michigan. All right, so at this time, we would ask the students to file on very quickly from the front row first with their special instruments so we can have our last part of the presentation for tonight. Thank you. 2 minutes on the clock, please. Here we go, students.
As we wrap down this evening's concert awards presentation, I'd like to thank everybody for coming out this evening and supporting our Basel bands. And we look forward to talking with you out in the cafeteria with a reception following. And students will be turning in their uniforms. We'll start with seniors first, then underclassmen following. We do need to strike the stage this evening, so if we have the extra hands on stage, the chairs can stay racked, but all the stands and everything and percussion goes back to the band room in 807. So we could use a hand with that if you're available. So our drum majors this past year, Annalise and Juliana, one of their final duties is to put together a series of leadership workshops in preparing students for next year's leadership and next year's drum majors. And they did a fantastic job right before spring break. We set up 3 dates. They organized and ran from beginning to end three 2-hour workshops in preparing for this. We've had This year, over 26 dedicated students aspiring to be drum majors and section leaders have taken part in these leadership workshops. So if you took part in these workshops, would you please stand now? Yesterday was the culmination of these workshops, and we had 10 students who auditioned for the position of drum major. So if you auditioned for drum major, would you please stand for recognition? We would like to recognize those students for their hard work and dedication to the Hazlett Band program at this time. After an audition in which students have demonstrated marching, teaching, conducting, and an interview, the panel selected the two drum majors for the 2018 Viking Marching Band. Please join us in congratulating Caden Bowers and Brianna Wilhite.
Thank you so much. Please join us for a reception, and please allow the seniors to get their uniform in first. Thank you. Band, dismissed.
First, you got
what?